digital design. Last week, I left you with some problems, and I hope you have found the best way to solve them. Let's start off with a simple one. How do we make an animation or GIF?
Photoshop. Compared to other video making software, Photoshop enables you to make a GIF in just a few minutes.
Wow, great answer. Now on to the next question. What is the best way to make a text event?
I think we should use Photoshop too. Photoshop is the best tool to make any kind of custom font.
Wow, what a smart class we have. Next, we're going on to a more difficult one. What if you want to make a 3D effect on a 2D image?
Although it sounds like a very boring thing, I would also go with Photoshop because it's really simple to use.
It's great that you all chose Photoshop. Let's see if we will continue to get the same answer for our last question. How do you perform a face swap?
Definitely Photoshop. You can transfer yourself or anyone else into whatever they would like to be.
Well, clearly Photoshop is a very powerful program.
We love Photoshop!
Yeah, Photoshop is a boom.
Remember class, with Photoshop, anything is possible.
We love Photoshop!
Hello everyone, here's Mu Zhen and my teammate Yuqi, Nina and Jen. As shown in the video, Photoshop can do anything with the digital design. Since Photoshop is such a broad topic, and it made... Since Photoshop is such a broad topic and it may take you a year to totally master it, so we are only going to give you some introduction to basic function of the Photoshop and to invoke your interest. And maybe someday you will become one of the profession in Photoshop. We will focus on four functions. First, making GIF. Second, text effect. Third, 3D effect. And finally, face swap. As a start, a relatively easy making GIF may give you some basic concept to use the Photoshop. The first step to use the Photoshop to make a GIF is to find a sprite sheet on the go. You will get a picture with a bunch of movement just like this and open it in the Photoshop. The second step is to choose the movement you want to use with the select tool in the Photoshop. You can open your handout to see what this select tool looks like. And these three are the movements I want to use. Then select one of these, right click, layer via a copy, you will get the different layers with single character. Just like this, you will have three characters with its own layers. Now since we don't want a movement from layer one, which is our spreadsheet, we can simply delete the layer one. And then we will drag all characters together so that they will move in just one point. Now they're all together. It looks creepy, but it's fine. We will make an animation. At the bottom of the Photoshop, there is a button create video timeline. Click it, you will get four trials for each layer. And we only need one trial, so you can simply resize the trial for the other layers and drag them to the fourth trial. I know it's a little abstract. You can view a handout, or I prepare a video later for you to view. And now actually our GIF is made up. You can click the play button to see how your animation looks like, or you can simply save it as a GIF. Now magnific contrast. And then you open, you create a Photoshop file, and then you just click the text button on the left side and write down the word you want. I just use a letter as an example. And if you want to move the letter, you will hold the control key and drag the letter, or it's control for Windows and command for Mac. And then you can choose whatever fonts you want, but I suggest you use the fonts looks like handwritten. And then you need to convert your text to a smart object. It's on the lower right button, and you right click the text and choose convert to smart object. And then you need to drag your downloaded picture into the Photoshop and put it on the top of the letter. And now you need to move out the useless space. In order to do that, you just hold the key control and click the text layer here and make it like that. And you click the little square here and to create a layer mask. And then the result will be like that, a G-shape with the picture. And then you need to liquefy your letter. In order to do that, you click the file button on the top and choose liquefy, and it will pop up a new window like that. In order to zoom in, you need to hold control and space and click the place you want to zoom in. And then you need to liquefy it. Make sure your brush is about the width of the letter G, and you just drag, click and drag like that. You need to brush it and liquefy it, and then it will be like that. Like you can see, here are some water drops, and it makes more like a paint text. And then here is other examples, and now you learn a new text font by yourself. And Nina will introduce how to make a 3D effect on a 2D image.
Hi guys, I will introduce how to make a 3D effect. First, what is different between 2D and 3D? And 2D is flat, using only X and Y dimensions, and if you turn inside, and you will just see a line. So, but 3D uses X, Y, Z dimensions. What is 3D effect? 3D effect encodes each eye's imaging using filters of different colors. In the painting world, how people draw their objects in 3D way, they use colors like this. They use colors to express 3D effect. You can clearly see the background and the person. They also use different sizes and to tell the relationship of the object that they use, which is only illustrated 3D effect. Last one, they use shadow and light to tell another 3D effect. So all in all, 3D effect is not only important in painting, but also in pictures. So if we want our pictures look more attractive, it's important for us to know how to make a 3D effect on Photoshop. So Photoshop can help us to make a 3D effect in a few steps. So here, first you need to open your Photoshop and find the file, open your image you want to edit. After that, you need to find the layers to duplicate your layers. And tips here, don't forget to rename your layer for your new layers to distinguish your old one. blending, you need to unclick red and then click continue. And then move layers to the right. If you have more layers, you can unclick more channels here and make them to the right. Because we have moved the layers, so there's a area that doesn't match 3D effect. So we need to crop our image. After that, our new 3D image is done. So it is definitely cool, much cooler than the original one. So why learning how to make a 3D effect is necessary? Because there are a lot of other 3D cool stuff improves based on 3D effect. So, and Photoshop can help to learn basically how it works. So here is a 3D film. As we all know, 3D film is an motion picture. So after you learn how to make a 3D effect on the Photoshop, you can go further to make your own new 3D film. So if you want your photos and selfies be more unique and brilliant, you on your phone, try out these apps. Here's Huji, Vesco, and Snapseed. So what's more, there are lots of incredible and funny functions on the Photoshop, and Jen will show us one of those.
Hi guys, I'm Jen, and I think one of the best ways to portray just how powerful Photoshop is through a little thing called a face swap. So, Professor Warner has graciously allowed us to transform him into anything that we could choose, so we thought, who better than the one and only Fabio? So today I'll be live demonstrating to show you just how easy and quickly a face swap can be done. So first off, I did the hardest part already, which is you just really want to make sure that the eyes are lined up here. So the next step is to hit Control B, and this brings up the color balance box. So you'll see that I'll definitely have to take out probably some red, add some blue, maybe a bit of yellow in there. And the next step is to pick out an eraser. So you have to make sure that you get a soft-edged eraser with a lot of opacity. So you can adjust the size. Okay, not on this computer, I guess. Normally you can adjust the size with the bracket tools, but I guess it's different for here. So this is a pretty good eraser. You'll just want to literally take the edges away. Different than on the MacBook, but essentially you just want to like take the hard edges away, and that's why you want a soft eraser. But okay. So the next step would be you want to hit Command L, and that brings up the levels box. So this is where things can get maybe realistic, a little weird. Essentially, you're just going to be taking away some of the color to make it blend a bit more. Interested in Photoshop but concerned about the price, you can always download the Microsoft Remote desktop client. So what that does is allow you to access your Windows account. So virtually from anywhere, wherever you are, you can access Illustrator, Adobe InDesign, Photoshop, all of those things. So we put together a little video, but I don't think we have time for this. But if anyone has any questions about Remote Lab, just let us know. So feel free to try out some tutorials online. There are so many different options to help you learn Photoshop. So just to name a few, the creators of Photoshop themselves made helpx.adobe.com. DeviantArt is a great website because that's all users submitted. And then PS Hero, what's unique about that is that it actually offers free PSD files and custom shapes available for download. Lately, we've been talking a whole lot about the importance of a strong but succinct resume. Help set yourself apart from the rest of the pack with Photoshop and design skills. Learning Photoshop and its tools can open up a side to your creative mind that you never even knew existed before. Give Photoshop a try. Your inner graphic designer awaits. Thank you.